Today we're going to take a look at Apple Pay on the Apple Watch. If you aren't familiar with Apple Pay, it allows you to make purchases in stores or restaurants without needing your physical credit or debit card. And the Apple Watch supports Apple Pay. Let's take a look at Apple Pay on the Apple Watch. Now, if you're at a merchant and you want to pay with Apple Pay, what they're going to have is a reader. So what you need to do is you need to make sure that the merchant accepts Apple Pay. Most of them do these days. It seems to be a pretty commonplace thing. I can even use it at McDonald's, the drive-thru at McDonald's. But when I want to use Apple Pay with my Apple Watch, what I need to do is just press in on the side button here two times. When I press in on that side button, what it'll do is it'll pull up all of my cards in my wallet. So let's go ahead and press it in twice here. And there's my card. Now this is the default card. I'll show you how you can change that later on in the video, but this is the default card. I don't have to use this card. I do have other cards. If I just swipe up, or if I use the digital crown, what I'm able to do is select which card I want to use. When it is pulled up here, you're going to see it's just hold near reader. So now all I need to do to pay with this card is hold this near the reader, and then my Apple Watch will pay using this card, will pay the merchant. So that's basically all we have to do is just press this in twice, one, two. We have all of our different cards, and then we just swipe up to select the card we want to use. And then once we select the card, we just hold it near the reader at the merchant. Pretty simple. Now we do have a few options. As I mentioned, we can set a default card. We can add more cards. Maybe you don't have a card. How do you add cards to your Apple Pay, to the Apple Watch? Well, again, this is all done through the Watch app on the iPhone. So let's go back over to my Watch app on the iPhone and see how we can manage our cards. So I'm in the Watch app on my iPhone again, and I'm looking at my watch. From here, what we need to do is we need to swipe up until we find Wallet and Apple Pay. When we tap on Wallet and Apple Pay, we're able to manage all of our cards that are on the Apple Watch, and if we want to add a new one, we just tap on Add Card, follow the instructions. It's pretty simple to do. It uses the camera on your iPhone, and you can easily add more cards. Now we can also see what other cards we have in app. So when I swipe up here, you're going to see that I have other cards on my iPhone. So there's an Apple account on my iPhone. It has not been added to my Apple Watch. So from here, what I'm able to do is add it to my Apple Watch because I'm in the Watch app on the iPhone again. So anything that I do here is for the Apple Watch. And then if you're near a place where you can use public transportation, you can also add an Express Transit card. So then you can just hold your Apple Watch up to the public transportation kiosk and then pay with your Apple Watch. Now we can also set up a default card. As you saw, mine is my Huntington Bank account, but what I'm able to do is change this to a different account. How do we do that? Well, again, this is all done through our Watch app on the iPhone and in that Wallet and Apple Pay. So let's go back over to my iPhone here, and I'm in the Wallet and Apple Pay. And if you look here, you're going to see we have a default card. From here, all I need to do is just tap on which card I want to use as my default card. If you use this on a computer or anything like that, you can also set up an address. Where do you want your items shipped? Well, you're going to see that we have a shipping address here. We can also add a shipping address in there. So that is how we manage our cards as well as add our cards. The last thing I want to mention is we can also view our transactions. We can do this from the Wallet app on the iPhone, or we can do this on the Apple Watch itself. So let's take a look at this on the iPhone first. So I'm going to go back over to my iPhone. What we need to do is open up the Wallet app. I have it here on my home screen, so I just tap on that. And it's just like opening up a wallet. You're going to see I have all of my different cards in here. So what I want to do is take a look at my card using Apple Cash. So when I tap on that, what it's going to do is open up that card, and then I can see all of the transactions. And when we swipe up, what I can do is view them by month as well. Let's see how we do this on the Apple Watch itself. We can also view this on the Apple Watch. So let's go back over to my Apple Watch. Again, we need to open up the Wallet app. There's basically two ways to do that. Let's go with the traditional way where we have to go to our app. So I press in on the digital crown and I'm looking at all of my apps. Now what I do is I just scroll up until I find my Wallet app. And when I tap on that, I can view all of my different cards. But there is an easier way to do this. All we really need to do when we're looking at our watch face, or if we're in an app, is just press in on the side button twice, just like we're going to be using Apple Pay. So now what I'm going to do is press in on it twice, one, two, and it opens up the Wallet app. So we don't really have to go over to all of our apps and tap on that wallet, look for that Wallet app. We can just double press in on the side button. All right, so now how do we see the transactions? Well, I'm going to scroll up to choose my Apple Cash here. And then I just tap on it, and again, you're going to see the latest transactions. I'm just scrolling up, and I can see all of the latest transactions. So that is how we use Apple Pay on the Apple Watch. Basically, we set this up through the Watch app on the iPhone. We add our cards in there. We can set up a default card. Once we do that, when we're at a merchant that accepts Apple Pay, all we have to do is just press in on the side button twice, and then we hold it up to that reader, and it'll pay that merchant. You can select which card you want to use before you hold it up to the reader. It's pretty simple to do. Like I said, I use it as much as I possibly can. It's actually more secure than using a traditional credit card. The reason is it sends a token instead of sending that credit card number. So it's a one-time token that the Apple Pay uses or sends over to the merchant. So then if someone were to intercept that token, it wouldn't be able to use it because it's a one-time use token. So it's actually more secure than using a credit card, because when you use a credit card, somebody could get that number and possibly use that elsewhere. We've all heard the horror stories. Well, with Apple Pay, that can't happen. So that is how we use Apple Pay on the Apple Watch.